So, once your students have filled out their WISER worksheet, you probably want to be able to see how they're doing. So what you're going to do is on the worksheet that you've assigned to them, you click on the three dots, and then you're going to go ahead and click on Answers. And this will take you to your current assignment that I've clicked on, and it shows me how my individual did. He got 5 of the 12 points. He spent 3 minutes, so I know he took a long time to do this, or maybe not. Exactly when it was completed, and now you notice that the worksheet is locked, so he cannot do anything with it to change his answers. I look at my first question, which was label the 5 regions of Virginia, and he got, the computer has graded him as 2 of the 5 being correct. However, you'll notice that the Piedmont region is actually correct, it's just misspelled. So what I can do is click on it and turn it green, and now his points went up because I can say, you know what, I know Mark knows that that's the Piedmont region, he just can't spell it. Same thing with Appalachian Plateau. Now, this is the coastal plain, so that's a personal decision whether or not you're going to be generous and accept that. But again, if you have spelling errors but it's the right answer, click on it green so that they can get that positive feedback. I can look at my next question, what region do we live in? And he left me a voice answer, so I can click to play it. And then what I can choose to do is either give him written feedback and say, great job, or I can go ahead and choose to give audio feedback and give him other feedback. For the purposes of these videos, I'm not gonna go ahead and record the audio because I think it will mess things up. But I just want you to know that it's here, so just click on that button, start talking, and then go ahead and upload it. And then, because this was an open question, WISER doesn't know how to grade it, so I need to grade it. And either it was a right or a wrong, so I'm going to add a 1 in there, because let's say he got it right. I can also decide if I want to give him a little bit of love, too. Again, here's my multiple choice question, and it's checked correctly. And again, I can give comments through the voice or typing. And then at the bottom, I have a box for general feedback. And I can say like a message here like, I think you should take more time when filling out, when completing your work. And then if I want, I can add an emoji because, you know, everybody loves emojis. I can change the color if I'd like. I have a whole bunch of colors. I can change the background. You have all kinds of things that you can put here. Or again, you can leave an auditory comment. Then when I'm done, I'm going to click Apply Feedback. And now when my student goes back to see his worksheet, he's going to see all the feedback and be able to listen to everything that I have shared with him. So that is how you see student results and give them feedback. Hope that's helpful.